body, and a man works free of the diet complex and lives without concentration upon the form life, eating that food which is available and upon which he can best attain his life efficiency. In preparation for certain initiations, a vegetable diet has in the past been deemed essential. But this may not always be the case, and many disciples prematurely regard themselves as in preparation for initiation. On the spleen. The spleen is the most important agent of the life force, but it is the life force inherent in matter itself, independently of form. It is therefore closely related to the planetary physical body. It is the externalization of a very important center. There are three centers in the body with allied externalizations which are basically essential to life. 1. The heart center and the physical heart itself. In use the life principle, the spirit aspect is located. Life and spirit are one. 2. The head center and the brain in which the consciousness principle, the soul aspect, is located. 3. The pranic center and the spleen, in which the life of matter itself, the matter aspect, is located. Copyright 1998 Lucas Trust. 198. The Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. You must bear in mind that, as HPV points out, the dense physical body is not a principle. It is atomic matter which is held in form by etheric substance, under the control of the soul. It is automatic in its response, and reacts to the outer world of impacts and inner impulses. It has no initiatory life of its own. It is composed of units of energy, as is all else in nature, and has its own individual life. Its focus for the distribution of energy for this life is the spleen. In the spleen, the negative life of matter and the living energy of the positive etheric body are brought together, and then a spark, as it is called, is made between the inner living bodies of man through the medium of the etheric body and the physical plane. It is a reflection on the lowest rung of the evolutionary ladder, as far as man is concerned, and corresponds to the relation of soul and body or, on a higher turn of the spiral, of spirit and matter. On the vagus nerve. There are two powerful centers connected with the vagus nerve, the heart center and the center at the base of the spine. These two, when brought under the control of the soul, functioning through the head center, the Brahmarendra produce the raging of the Kundalini fire. This, when taking place, swings the entire nervous system into a special form of rhythmic activity and responsiveness, and it is through the stimulation and the control of the vagus nerve that this is accomplished. It is not the vagus nerve which is instrumental in raising the Kundalini fire, but the reverse situation. When the head, the heart and the center of the base of the spine are in magnetic and dynamic rapport, producing a radiatory effect, then they affect the vagus nerve and the fires of the body are unified and raised, producing purification and the opening of all doors. On the eye, there is a certain school of scientific theorists who are working on the theory that the eye is the declarative factor in the human body and the ruler of its right understanding. not read up on the eye a little and notice occult correspondences to the created world, and to the whole problem of life. The eyes and the soul are closely related and, speaking in the language of occultism, the right eye is the representative of the soul, and therefore the agent of. Copyright 1998 with this trust. 199. A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. Study, whilst the left eye is the representative of the personality, and the agent is a lower concrete mind. You will find it interesting to read what can be found in the Secret Doctrine and other books, including mine, on this subject. It will compel the conclusion that here is a field of investigation hitherto unopened and a teaching which will warrant careful study for the sake of the group, if for no other reason. On psychological causes of disease. New, psychological causes of disease. Register in brain symptoms before reflecting to other parts of the body. A sentence in the light of the soul has a bearing here. The brain, for instance, is the shadow, or the external organ of the mind, and it will be found by the investigator that the contents of the brain cavity have a correspondence to the aspects of the human mechanism found upon the mental plane. Bear in mind that the life force works through the heart, utilizing the bloodstream, whilst the consciousness aspect works through the brain, using the nervous system. This is the first and most important point to grasp. Psychological causes of disease register in the brain are those of a very low order in the solar plexus. They do not, however, make their presence felt as symptoms of disease in these places where they thus register. Their energies are forces which, when brought into contact with the energies of the body, produce, as a result and not before this point, those conditions to which we give the name of disease. The psychological causes are forms of energy, working out through the appropriate centers in the body, and these, in their turn, condition the glandular system. The secretion or hormone, generated under this esoteric stimulation, finds its way into the bloodstream, and the result of all this interaction can be either good health, as it expresses sound psychological causes, or poor health, as it expresses the reverse. It is the internal relation between the subtler energies, working through certain centers, plus the related endocrine system, with its relation to the bloodstream, that constitutes both the possibility of disease and its cure. But this recognition is still academically lacking. Much of the inherent psychology is grasped, but a gap still exists between the physical and the etheric bodies, and little recognition of the etheric body is yet academically afforded. There is yet no real understanding of the relation between the inner psyche and the outer form, via the etheric body. The study of the glands has somewhat helped, but medical science must go a step further and relate the glandular system to the inner centers. On problems of melancholia. These problems of melancholia are difficult to place and are due to a wide variety of causes. Copyright 1998 with this trust. 200. A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. We'll list them here, and the list may at some time serve you. 1. A sense of frustration, a thwarted wish life, or a recognition of a basic life failure. 2. A sense of dramatics, and a desire to figure importantly on the little stage of a person's life. This never materialize, but which does constitute an innate fix, so that the person is the victim of a well-developed thought form. 6. A tuning in, through oversensitivity, on the suffering and mass pain of the world. The cycle can be temporarily overcome by this. 7. This condition is very seldom brought about by any form of obsession such as an earthbound entity or a living vampire-like person. A very few such cases have been known, but they are too rare to be considered a factor. 8. Sometimes a person tunes in on a state of mass melancholia, such as can be found in our sanitariums or asylums. The condition has been nothing really to do with him, but being sensitive, he identifies himself with those who are suffering from acute melancholia. 9. Melancholia, as a symptom of disease, not of brain disease, is also fairly frequent and will disappear when the disease is under proper treatment. A person may be suffering from a combination of such causes, as for instance a combination, let us say of the causes in 1, 2, 6. Onchonium and psychosis. One of the departments of esoteric medicine in the future will concern itself with the law of cycles, lunar and solar. It will then be demonstrated as a fact, what has always been suspected and is now generally recognized, that the period of the full moon has a definite effect upon unbalanced people, upon the dreaming state and frequently conditioned quite drastically, the neurotic and erotic conditions so prevalent at this time. Copyright 1998 Lucas Trust. 201. A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. The tremendous increase in insanity and imbalance today is due to three major causes. 1. The transitional period of today producing a clash between the Aquarian and the Piscean forces has led to a condition which makes it very difficult for sensitive people to live normally at all. Express the idea in symbols, it is almost as if the race, after habituating itself to live on the earth,